Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Zinmara, and welcome to another episode of YLands. I have literally recorded this episode 4 times. I had a crash for the second time. Crashed the game, rebooted me basically right here, but I've also done a lot since then. Before that, I heard a recording where I was getting the light side and dark side mixed up. So, building tip for everybody, you know, every block that you build with, it in a sense has a light side and dark side. So, building a bamboo house. I have started and also completed a lot. I haven't done anything too gingerbread, man. What are you doing out here? Too crazy. Started the cotton farm, grain farm's doing a thing. I did a bunch of bamboo. I like it in the water like that. I also am really upset. I want to show you guys if you don't ever can talk. You don't already know. So in these little shallows you can plant stuff on them. So something like bamboo, even though technically this is salt water, looks kind of cool. So this is actually the second planting of the bamboo, because I cut it all down to, you know, make all this stuff, and then I replanted a bunch. I also have planted all the seeds that I got from the rainforest. All my rainforest, small trees, big trees, medium trees. I haven't done rainforest palms. In fact, you know what we could do? We can go plant one of these, and I don't think it'll go through. Maybe in a couple episodes we'll see how it's doing. That is all rubber trees, so I left the tropic island with about seven or eight rainforest seeds, rubber tree seeds. I then started and then took the rubber, chopped them all down, took the rubber, chopped them all down, and this is where we're at right now. If you don't know how to yet, you just, so you got your knife out, selected, and you get the extract rubber cube. Anything else, you don't even, it doesn't pop up. It's kind of basically the same thing with trees. You can come up here and extract resin and collect wood if you'd like to. The wood is little chunks. So that's what raw rubber looks like. That's what the tree looks like. So when you get to a decent spot and you've, you know, created your rubber farm, don't chop them down after you do this, because they will heal themselves. It's somewhere between 2 and 3 full days before, that's really loud, 2 and 3 days before they heal themselves completely and you can extract rubber again. Got pineapple farm going on pretty well. I'm gonna plant that palm. I think their leaves are darker, maybe. I can't remember. Oh no, you can't remember. So what we'll do is, because I know this is a coconut palm. Put a couple right here. Too close. Is that good? That's does it. Melon's mixed in with wild. I think they're called, yeah, wild. Those are acai berries from the acai trees that I planted. Haven't used them cooking yet, but they're nothing. They have nothing to do with the alchemist, as far as I can tell so far. We figured out how to make underwater. What is that? Water breathing potion. And that's essence of coral. So I believe just go grab coral and grind it down, and that becomes like powdery essence of coral. Alright, so today I want to basically build this wooden, or not wooden, but bamboo house. And I would like to get that done here within the next 20 minutes or so. Yeah, let's do that. One quick thing. I have started, you know, this is going to be my dining hall or something. This is going to be the bank. I was going to record it, but I'm still, this actually first, but I'm still kind of considering what I'm going to do with this spot. So this is going to be all like entrance to the bank, greeter desk or something, and then kind of like a vault with the locked counters here. Build a bunch of the bank safes, which would be I just had them here. Bank safe, tin steel plate, I gotta make a whole bunch of cogwheels. And then actually see how, how big they are. Oh, okay, so let's keep doing this. So, as best you can tell, light side. Dark side, light side, dark side. And that's part of the problem when you're building with it. You can't tell a whole lot with it, especially when you got the sun coming up. But just do that. That'll tell us that I was wrong. That I want to make a bamboo couple windows right there, so I'll leave that for now. Did I make long? Yep. Wrong way. Wrong side. Oh man. The more I dig into building stuff, I just start feeling like I just don't want to do it anymore. There we go. So that was that way. That way. I liked how that looked along with the corner pillar there. So that's why that's that way. You go like that. You like that. So far, so good. Ugh, I hate when it resets like that. Well, kind of have a winner. So this is a problem with the corner pieces. Is they have that dark side that matches perfectly. And they have a half dark side, which is annoying. And then they're bright. Oh, bright spot on the other side. And then half dark, half light. So I think we're just gonna leave it like that. Yes. It's like winning the lottery. Oh, so yeah, this is gonna be kind of a house. I'm also making it into a sushi bar. Was that too high? Yeah, that's right, I didn't. That's right. I did this. Getting a lot of skipping. So a coffee fill. I can tell you this, I envisioned it in my head, but it has been, I don't know, 2 or 3 days since I came back to this thing because I was so frustrated at it. I didn't want to, I guess the word would probably be burnout. It's really tall, you know? Yeah, I knew that's what I wanted to do right there. Buddy, not E. What? Making some progress on this thing, finally. Yeah, I like it. Looks pretty legit. So, well, I started a lot of it over. I really enjoy the dark side on the outside, obviously. That's why I'm doing it that way. And then the light side, it just makes it more, feel more light in here, I guess is the word. Why are you doing that? number three. Three is good. We got a storm rolling in. Come on. Keep it like that. Then put some chairs like right here. Make some bowls and plates on the front there, filled with fish or sea urchin. Sometimes it will alter or completely change its color, and this one not. Not gonna do it for us. Why, Lens? Why? No, we got it. We give them a break. It being early access, I've never been. Well, no, I have, but it's been a while since seeing a game actually enter early access. And being viable to play. I mean, you got ones out there, what, The Forest, they're doing some amazing great updates to that game, but it's been years in early access. PSJ was saying in one of his Stranded Deep episodes, what did he say, I think he said something to the effect of, early access is great, but it becomes kind of a problem, I guess, when there's not significant additions, changes, bug fixes, community involvement, getting the community together, just like YLands has. And really focusing on the game and getting everything right and doing it the right way. Oh, I wanted to go on a decent rant. Do I want long ones or short ones? I won't say the name of it, but the rant I wanted to go on off on is any game that has or claims to be associated as a MMO or massive multiplayer online MMORPG role-playing game, and it's server-based, which an MMO is server-based, however, their capacity isn't anywhere close to below 100. And I got a game a few weeks ago that, and I just blasted them on my review, and I told Steam, you know, that there's hundreds if not more games out there claiming to be MMO, and they simply aren't. Survive the Nights, you know, those kind of games where they've got a server cap of like 70, that is okay, but it's more, and it's good, but it's more, what's the word I'm looking for? It's more of like a co-op. And that's obviously not even close to a co-op, because co-op is 2, 3, 4 people playing together. I wanted to show you my orchids. Pretty little orchid farm. All the rainforest trees, rubber. I really need to get working on this thing. So, yeah, blasted them on my review. And it wasn't really the game itself, because they, I don't know how it works when you put it on Steam as an early access game, but I don't know how much control they actually have of the tags that it falls under, other than the game's name. The genre, stuff like that. So it might not even be the developer's fault. It might be a Steam thing. That's why I talked to Steam about it. Forgive the voice. And, you know, getting over, not really getting over the sickness, but kind of the icky. Alright, let's see if we can get something done. How tall are those? One, those four. Oh, come on, Sticky. 1, 2, 3, yeah, 4. Okay. I don't think so. None of that's gonna really. Maybe it will, maybe it No. Oh, good lordy. I have been contemplating. To kind of do next once I contemplating on what to do next. For the game, because we really are kind of getting to a point of I'm only getting mildly frustrated right now. Well, if you use the right controls, maybe it'll work. What's going through my mind is you can have like a little overhead on the roofing. So I've been thinking about doing another game, something definitely more. Serious concentration needed, right? So, How long are we running? We're crossing 35 minutes. It's so difficult for me right now. Talking constantly, especially during a build, because, well, blatantly, I'm kind of inside my head a lot, so the more I'm used to thinking that out in my head and not having to articulate it in words. Cotton mouth too. You guys see a wood door? Is there a bamboo door? Not that. No. I do have to say though, this bed is awesome. Whoops. You can't rotate that. I disappear. Haha. Maybe corner? And the more traditional floor mats. Three? Yeah, that works. Oh, 40, come on. Oh, because that's not... Third time. Okay, so we don't have a bamboo door. What can we make? No, not a cactus. I need to find some planks or make some. I've been kind of dropping stuff where I expect to, you know, maybe do a project or something to kind of remind me. Wood, and then I'm going to try to stay there once it stood to the door. What can we use? Hopefully it doesn't pull a snowman and just stay floating in midair. Alright, so they don't stay there and I can pick them up. It's gun to do it. Just gonna do the one though. No inventory, silly. Okay. Yeah. Yeah, that's not gonna work. Looks kind of cool though. What do I kind of need to do? What do we have? We're at 45 minutes. That's kind of long. Stick. I'm gonna have to turn probably some stuff off from now on. I really need to get the. Oh, I really made my fan start kicking. I really need to really need to turn it down so that I can quit running into that. Crafting and bamboo boot. Ignore the beeping. Gonna look at some oriental buildings and kind of see. Now I'd have to go up one more. Yeah. So they would need to pick that up. So 1, 2. You are in the way. Oh well, guys, I know this was probably kind of a boring episode. I'm gonna finish the rest offline on this on the bamboo sushi bar, and so yeah, thank you guys for watching. Smash subscribe, smash the like button, that would be greatly appreciated. And next episode I am going to be mostly down here, and we are going to cook ourselves up a locksmith and figure out everything we can do with the rubber. I do need to mention, with the rubber you have to have sulfur with the rubber. course I don't. As such, I've got quite a bit of it, so yeah, that's right there. Woot. Yep. Alright, guys, thank you very much for watching. Have a wonderful day, and see you next time.